Today marks the start of a new judicial term for the U.S. Supreme Court. The Archbishop of Washington tells the justices new beginnings are always good for the soul. His Excellency Wilton Gregory, who was installed as Archbishop of Washington in May, praised the High Court will be a reflection of God's justice and mercy. The Archbishop was the principal celebrant and homilist for yesterday's Red Mass for the justices, which is held annually on the Sunday before the court's new term. The Mass also includes prayers for lawyers, law students, and government officials. Join me now with a preview of the cases for this new term is Amy Howe, reporter for SCOTUSblog.com and the blog Howe on the Court. Amy, welcome back to the program.
Thanks for having me.
We learned Friday that the justices will take up a case involving abortion. There's a challenge to a pro-life law in Louisiana which requires abortion doctors to have hospital admitting privileges. How significant is this case, do you think, and what will you be looking for here in the arguments?
It's significant for a couple of different reasons. The first is simply that it's the first abortion case that the Supreme Court has heard in a couple of years. It's also important because the Supreme Court, just a couple of years ago, struck down a similar law from Texas. And so it'll be an opportunity for the justices to take another look and say whether or not they're going to follow that law and uphold the Louisiana law or strike it down. But at the same time, what we're also going to be looking for, at the same time that the Supreme Court granted the abortion providers' petition to review the constitutionality of the Louisiana law, they also granted an appeal by the state, which asked the justices to weigh in on whether or not the abortion providers have a legal right to sue, known as standing, mm-hmm. to challenge this law at all, because it's a health and safety regulation, they say, that's intended to benefit patients. So yeah. We'll be looking very carefully at that to see what the justices think. Justice Clarence Thomas, mm-hmm. for example, has said that they may very well not have this kind of right at all.
Interesting that you mentioned the justice, too, because this is the first time the retirement of Justice Anthony Kennedy that the court is taking up, as you mentioned, the issue of abortion. How do you think the makeup of the court now that we have Brett Kavanaugh, Neil Gorsuch, will impact the decision?
It's going to be very interesting to watch. You know, certainly President Trump, when he was running for president, promised to nominate justices who were going to overturn Roe versus Wade, and that's not directly at issue necessarily in this case. But we do know that back in February, when a lower court had upheld the constitutionality of this Louisiana law, the abortion providers came to the Supreme Court and asked them to block the state temporarily from enforcing the law while they could file this appeal to the Supreme Court. And it was actually the Chief Justice, John Roberts, who joined the court's more liberal justices to put the law on hold. So it seems like he could very well be the swing vote on this case, even though he was in the dissent in the Texas case a couple of years ago.
Very interesting. I want to ask you about another hot button topic that will come up, guns. We learned the court is moving forward on a case related to the Second Amendment. Tell us about this case. What sort of that's the heart of this out of New York?
So it's a New York City rule that even if you have a licensed handgun, restricted your ability to take it really out of your house and prohibited licensed gun owners from taking their guns outside of the city, including to go to target practice outside of the city, including for people who own second homes mm-hmm. outside of the city. And so there was a challenge under the Second Amendment. The Supreme Court agreed to hear the case earlier this year. And it was a significant announcement because the Supreme Court back in 2008 and 2010 had said essentially there is a Second Amendment right to have a handgun in your home. It hadn't said anything more than that. Mm-hmm. So the Supreme Court could say more about the right to have a handgun outside of your home. New York City actually over the summer changed the law significantly and had urged the justices to dismiss the case. And the Supreme Court just today said we're going to move forward and hold oral argument in December on the Second Amendment question. So they could very well issue what could be a very significant Second Amendment ruling.
And that's just one of the many reasons we're following that topic as well as the abortion issue. So many important cases coming up, and if we had more time, we'd talk in more detail about it.
It's a big term.
It is. It's going to be a big one. Amy Howe, reporter for SCOTUSblog.com at Howe on the Court. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks for inviting me.